trouble. You're gonna see that your words are dangerous. Your talk is cheap. I'm standing here.
Making his way to the ring, weighing in at 323 pounds, Kane!
ECW is in Biloxi, Mississippi. Joey Styles and Taz at ringside, and courtesy of the SmackDown ECW Talent Exchange, we're going to start things off with the one and only Big Red Machine. WrestleMania 24, there will be a 24-man Battle Royal. And immediately following, the winner of the Battle Royal will challenge Chavo Guerrero for the ECW Championship. And Taz, we now know that Kane will be one of the 24 superstars from Raw, SmackDown, and ECW competing in that Battle Royal.
And from Jacksonville, Florida, weighing in at 231 pounds, Elijah Burke.
How are you feeling if you're Chavo Guerrero, knowing that Kane is going to be in that Battle Royal?
I wouldn't feel too happy, I'll tell you that right now. I've personally been in the ring with Kane. Not fun. It makes for a rough night.
And Elijah Burke may be about to find that out firsthand. Although Burke has uncanny athletic abilities. But one would think that Burke's going to have to stick and move against Kane.
Yep, the thing is with Kane, he takes up most of the ring, and I don't just mean by Kane's size, it's his quickness that's deceiving.
Kane goes about 7 feet tall, 300 pounds. As you said, Taz, Kane a quick 300 pounds. And did I mention Kane throws a mean uppercut?
I mean, come WrestleMania, I mean, Kane has loads of big match, main event, you know, matches under his belt. Therefore, 24-man Battle Royal at WrestleMania. Gotta look at Kane as a favorite already. We don't know who else is in it.
As a 7 feet tall, super heavyweight, I think Kane would have an advantage. Elijah Burke almost went through the barricade. Do you think right now Kane is sending a message to ECW champion Chavo Guerrero?
Or the other 23 competitors that are going to be in the Battle Royal?
Look at the unbelievable, almost unlimited power of Kane.
See, what Kane does so well, keeps the pressure on, keeps the heat on your body. Look at the power here of the Big Red Machine.
Right now, Taz, what exactly is Kane trying to do to Elijah Burke?
I mean, one would say maybe behead. Right, exactly. Elijah Burke.
Although if I think one lost his head, grammar wouldn't be of the utmost importance. Kane just unleashing, pushes his knees right to the kidneys of Elijah Burke.
I mean, if you are one of the other 23 participants come WrestleMania in a Battle Royal to face the ECW champion, how do you get rid of Kane in that match? You know, that's the question.
They take several superstars to get Kane out of that ring. And again, this is not something we normally see from Kane.
Well, you just read my mind, Joe. I agree. And it's, you know, Kane, I mean, maybe he's trying to send a message to Chavo, the ECW champion, Chavo Guerrero. And Elijah Burke got to try and get to a vertical base, create some separation between himself and Kane. Like that.
Kane, thus far, controlling the pace of this matchup.
You see Burke's knees buckle?
has, what does that uppercut feel
well,
like?
Well, it hurts, and you don't want to make Kane angry. And that could make Kane angry. Oh! He said something about an uppercut, eh?
Burke's got a pretty mean uppercut of his own. It's an amateur boxing background. Burke now opening up in a corner. Great timing by Elijah Burke, but Ken Burke have, wait a minute. We see the Elijah Express.
Well, what goes up must come down.
The Express just got derailed. There are 23 other superstars from Raw, SmackDown, and ECW, as well as the reigning ECW champion, Chavo Guerrero, who hopefully were watching that matchup very carefully.
Ever so dangerous, ever so dominant, ever so destructive is Kane. Watch this, the speed of Burke, but boom, got caught. And that's what you got to be careful of come WrestleMania. If you're in that battle wall, to face ECW champion against the quick hands of Kane and the power.
Look at the height on the chokeslam.
Not a good way to spend a Tuesday night, buddy.
And that could be Chavo Guerrero come WrestleMania.